एवरीवन, लेट्स कंटिन्यू द लेसन. ओके, हाई अप इन द कूलर एयर द वल्चर फ्लू. यू नो ऑन द हाई अल्टीट्यूड देयर इज अ जोन ऑफ कूल एयर. ऑल ऑफ यू लर्न इन इन ज्योग्राफी द वल्चर फ्लाई इन दैट कूलर एयर जोन. ओके, हरी अलॉन्ग ही कॉल्ड. द कैमल इज नॉट फार ऑफ बट द लायन कुड नॉट हरी एनी मोर. The hot sand had burned his paws. He could go no further. Stop, he shouted to the others. Let us go back to the forest. I do not care to try camel meat. The lion's king advisor was frightened. The forest was far behind them and they did not know how to get the lions back home. Okay. Here, look. The other animals walking on the hot sand, so they did not go faster. Above all, the hot sand has burned the lion king's paws. Okay, so he did not want to go further. He cancelled his desire of trying camel's meat. And now the king said, "Let's go back to the forest." But it is very difficult because already the lion king's paws were burned. How can he walk? So king's advisors were frightened. Okay. The leopard wanted to run away. He did not want to face this situation. The vulture wanted to watch and wait to eat the lions later on. Desire of vulture. Vulture wanted the king lion to die in the desert so that he could eat his meat. Okay. But the clever fox thought of a plan. Off into the desert he ran, saying, "I will bring some help." He ran away to the desert and he said, "I will bring some help." After running for some time, the fox found the camel. The camel was indeed surprised to see him. "Hurry up, friend camel," said the fox. "Our king wants you to you at once." "Your king?" said the camel. "Who is that? I do not know any king. I only know my master, for whom I carry goods across the desert." Look here. The fox was cunning. He addressed the camel as a friend camel. He was not his friend, but he said it so that the camel think of him as a friend and follows him without getting any suspect. Look here. But fox showed his cleverness and he smartly brought the courteous camel to the king. Okay. "Our king, the lion, he killed your master," said the fox. "Now you are free and the lion has invited you to live at his court. Come along." Look here. Camel did not know about any king because in desert area there is no animal king. Camel know only the master for whom the camel work. He carries the loads for him. He carries the goods for him. Okay. But the camel followed the fox. When the fox and the camel reached the lion's camp, the vulture and the leopard were surprised. Even the lion looked pleased, in spite of his burnt paws. The camel was presented to the king. He agreed to serve them the lion in return for a home at his court. Look here. It was unexpected for all animals, like vulture and leopards. Okay, the camel followed the fox and fox and camel reached the lion's camp. The lion looked pleased. He was become very happy. Then fox said, "Get on the camel's back, your majesty," said the fox. We will return home. Fox said to the lion king, "Sit on the camel's back and we will return now." Okay. He was grateful to the king for inviting him to remain at his court. So camel was always become the camel was become happy and he said yes to return. He said yes to go to the forest. The lion at the once jumped into the onto the camel's back. His courtier and fox and leopard jumped. Jumped up behind him, and with the vulture flying ahead as a guide, they set off on the long journey back to the forest. Fox smartly brought the courtiers and the kings back to the forest on the camel's back. When the travelers reached the forest, they were all tired and hungry. The fox and leopard and the vulture looked at the camel. Then they looked at each other and smiled hungry smile. They want to eat the camel meat. Okay. They had brought the camel for the king's dinner and now it was time for the feast. The king lion knew what his courtiers were thinking. He called the camel to him. King lion knew what is in his courtiers' mind. So he called the king. Camel. Friend Camel, he said, I have to thank you for saving my life. You are welcome to live at my court as long as you like. I promise you my protection. The lion's courtier was shocked about his saying. King Lion promised the camel to protect to give him protection. So they were shocked. Had they not risked their lives so that he would try camel meat up, and the king wanted to let the camel live? They were surprised. The courtiers were not pleased with his decision. The courtiers were not happy with the decision of King Lion. Yet they could do nothing, but they can't do anything. Okay. Now the king's, the lion's paws were so badly burned that he could not go hunting. But that did not keep him from growing very hungry indeed. So he called fox, leopard and vulture and said, don't you see that I am ill and hungry? Go and get me some food. The courtiers had to obey the king. So out they went. They did not go far. They sat down in a safe place and discussed what they could do. They make a plan there. I know, said the fox after a while. We shall make the camel ask to be eaten. He told the others of his plan. They all agreed. They all means leopard and vulture. So back they went to the king. First the vulture stepped forward. Because of their planning, so the vulture stepped forward and said to the lion king, Your Majesty, he said, bowing low, we have found no food, but we cannot let your majesty suffer. I am a poor creature, eat me. What the vulture said, they have not found any food, so eat me. The fox, then fox come forward and the fox pushed the vulture aside and said, I have more meat on me. He cried, eat me, your majesty. He said, the fox come forward and said, eat me, your majesty. Now the leopard rushed forward. I am not much good, he cried, but I could make a meal for the king. Now they make a plan and they come after each other. Fox and first come vulture, then came fox and then came leopard and they said, King Lion, eat me. Oh. So
The camel listened to all these offers. He do as much he thought. He was generous and kind, so he want to do some for Lion King. Your Majesty, he said, I too am willing to give my life for you. Please eat me instead of these old friends of yours, who will be more useful than I am. He was generous and kind, and he offered himself as a food for the hungry king. And this was what the fox and leopard and the vulture were waiting for. They make a plan to offer them to the king. They prepare to jump at the camel, but the lion stopped them. They want to eat the camel, but the lion stopped them. You are all good and loyal subjects, he said. My heart is touched by your offers. I accept them all. I shall eat you in the order in which you offered yourself. The vulture and the fox and the leopard were shocked. It was unexpected for them, because king said, I shall eat you in the order in which you offered yourself. So they become frightened, and they flew away. Flew the vulture, away ran the fox and the leopard. They were never seen in the forest again. They flew away in the fear, without realizing that the king would not actually kill them. But they were very frightened. Okay. The king laughed to see them go. Then he turned to the camel and said, you have been loyal and good. You shall be my friend as long as we are alive. The camel was happy and grateful. The lion thought to himself, to be king is good, but to be kind is better. What the king said? To be king is a good, but one who show the kindness to others, it is a better thing. Okay? Bye.